Hi everyone, this is Billy. I've redesigned my flow valve so I have a better base that is secure with the screw. Like this. And then we've got the flow valve on top and the box. So the box is secure to the base through the screw. Like this. Screw and nuts are printed from the 3D printer, and then you get a flow valve. Flow valve is important to control the type of hydroponics that I'm using, called Kratky hydroponics, which is the lazy man's hydroponic. Once you put the plant in, water level will be kept at 2 cm deep by this flow valve. And at the end of the flow valve, we fit a nutrient tank, and using gravity pull, the nutrient will continue to flow to the flow valve, and the flow valve will control water level is only at 2 cm deep. This will allow the roots of the plants to get more air, and it will grow healthily. So I designed a few different models. This one is the flow valve, using the thin silicon tape to seal the inlet pipe. Okay. The second design I have is, again, using the thin silicon tape, but I put the inlet pipe to the top so it can fit from the top. So depending on how your growth bed is designed for hydroponics, you can choose the side fit flow valve, which is fit from the side, or the top fit flow valve, which is fit from the top. So if you have the side fit flow valve, I have another design that you can use a thick 3M leakage tape instead of the silicon tape. The 3M leakage tape is easier to find, and you can just squeeze it inside this hole. So this 3M leakage tape is around 4 millimeter thick, and squeeze down to 3 millimeter, so it can be securely pushed inside this hole, and can use to seal the inlet. Okay, and let me show you how it looks after printing. So to make the flow valve, we need a number of components. First is to print out the 3D model. You can download the model from the Fingeris link that I provided. There's a box and also the flow valve. The flow valve itself is sealed with air gap inside the box. So you need to make sure you use good material to avoid leakage. If the leakage happens, it won't work. Okay, there are different type of design, but for all design, we will use this type of balloon sticks. The balloon stick, we need to cut out around 2 inches to form the fitting pipe, and then we can later on connect the water pipe here. Okay, so we need to insert it in here and adjust the length of the rod to match with the type of flow valve you're using. For example, this one. So we can squeeze this into the box. One side of the flow valve is circular, the other side has a notch. It's like rectangular. So we put one side with the full circle on one side, and then there's an arch here that will fit the rectangular one in. So we just fit one side first and then push it here. And then you will have the flow valve moving smoothly. If it's not smooth, you have to use some sandpaper to take out the roughed edges of the 3D printed plastic. Okay, so this is how you adjust how far you push this rod inside. The rod need to be grinder to smooth out the edges. So you will use a pile like this to pile through it, make sure the surface is flat and there's no rough edges. And then you will push it into the box like this. Push in. Push in like this. And then you can chop off the extra piece, leaving just a 1.5 inch to 2 inch stick outside that you can push the rubber pipe in. So let me show you how to fit this one. So again, put the round edges in the circle here, and then for the other one, just push it into the rectangular opening. Okay. So if it looks like this, this means the stick is pushing too far away. So let's pull it out a bit to adjust the base of the flow valve to be parallel with the base of the box, like this. Okay. So this is too much. Then just pull the stick out a bit until it's laying horizontal. Okay. Sometimes you want to be a little bit lower, because when time goes by, the silicon will be softened, and then the water level will change. So you need to adjust for that. Once you are okay with the level, you can test it underwater. Okay. Once testing is done, you can put some glue here to secure the position. I'm using this type of super glue, so you can just apply it here like this. Okay, just to let it dry, and then it will secure in place. Okay, this air hole is important. Make sure it's open, otherwise your flow valve will not be able to close completely, and then the water will be leaking. Okay, so these two holes here will be mounted on the base. Let me show you how to put in this silicone sticker. It is around 2 millimeter thick. Okay, let me show you how to put the sticker in. So use the side that have the pivots. Okay, we will cut a part of this out, around half an inch. Okay, and chop it in half as well. Then you can put it in the middle for the side valve, side feed valve. Put it in the middle like that, press hard, and then peel off the cover, which is another piece of plastic. Okay, like this. That will be it. And then for the one that is top fit, then you put a sticker on this side. So again, cut out a piece and then stick it around here, so it will cover all the top feed flow valve like this. Then you can chop off, peel off the top cover like this. Okay. Then there's the third type of flow valve, where you can fit in a thick 3M leakage tape. This is a 3M leakage tape. So what you do is you cut out a piece that look like a square, like this. If it's too long, you keep cutting until it's like a rectangle, right? Looking like a rectangle.
Okay, now it looks a bit like a rectangle. And you can put it in here. Let me do it one more. Okay, so you can put it in here. Just peel off the cover and then you can push it in. So squeeze it so that you can push it in from the edge like that. So it forms like a circle. Make sure the edge is flat. Okay, and then you will test whether it can conceal the inlet pipe. Okay, like this. Okay, if you find it's okay, then you can mount it. Okay, again, put one side in first, and then there's a rectangular notch here. Let's press up. Okay, if you find that it drops to the bottom, that means this deck is not pushed in enough. So continue to push in until you see a parallel. The flow valve is parallel with the edge of the base of the box. Okay, if it's not enough, you keep pushing. Okay. Sometimes you want to push further because the cotton may deform sometimes. So sometimes you want it to be a bit higher. Okay. So make sure it can drop freely. So that's it. For this one, try again this one. Put one side in and press through the notches. Okay, so adjust the edge. Okay, that's fine. And for the top fit one, we have this one. So I can push a stack in first and then push this one in. Okay. And then we adjust this stack, make sure it's in parallel position. Okay. Okay, so once we're satisfied with this one, we can connect it to the water pipe. This water pipe is linked to this big water tank. So this water tank is like this, it's a bottom fit. It's a switch. And then we connect to this flow valve. Okay, and the flow valve need to connect with the base. Push it into the base. This is the base of the screw. So you can clean out the base from the 3D printing model, and then you just need to secure the base to the base of your growth bed. Push it in. Okay. Then you have the plastic screw like this one that we can use to secure the box to the base. So we have the base stick to the growth bed, and then the flow valve box secure to the base, and the flow valve will be operating. This is the plant we are trying to grow, so let's see. Let me switch on the water pipe, and then you see the water will be coming out. Then we'll be measuring the depth of the water. So it should not exceed 2 centimeters. So water is coming out. Okay, water flow has now stopped, and you can check it's around 2 centimeters. So we usually wait for a whole night to see if the water level remains the same as 2 centimeters and not above it. So at the next day, if we find this testing is complete, we can install this flow valve at our growth bed. So this is another side fit flow valve. Okay, I will connect it to the pipe. Okay, let's check whether the growth bed is balanced. Parallel. Okay. And we can mount it to the base. Secure it by the screw. Okay. All set, then I will turn on the water pipe. So water will come out. Again, we'll test whether it can retain the 2 centimeter water level. Okay, water has stopped, and this is at 2 centimeter.
This is the end of my video. Thanks a lot for watching. If you like my video, click like, subscribe, and share with your friends too. Until next time, bye.